up here in the top right-hand corner of the map. The gentleman who's looking to make a little bit of a name, he is Scar. And we say that because his opponent is Oz. This guy has found himself into GSL a few times now. He's had some successes and is now here with Fnatic representing them in the bottom left in the red. He is Oz.
Pretty notorious when he played for FXO for saying that PvP at a time when it was thought to be kind of not a game of chance, but there were luck elements associated with it, basically coming out on record and saying, no, it has nothing to do with luck. In fact, come up against me and I will beat you if you believe that it's luck. So Oz is a relatively outspoken guy, very good player, and we'll see what he has to offer here. I do want to make an announcement out there. If you guys didn't catch our Twitter and Facebook before, of course, we're doing the DICE Invitational next week in Las Vegas, actually 1 week from today. Unfortunately, Azubu Violet had some visa issues and will not be able to attend. So that's out of our power. And, you know, we hope that he gets everything cleared up because we know he wants to, you know, go on and try and study here in the United States. So we hope that gets sorted out for him. In the meantime, though, Illusion, former Quantic player.
That's all I want to know. If we could tell everybody who's subbing in. And it's going to make it very exciting because now we're going to have two Terrans representing, one Protoss, one Zerg.
That's right.
And I'm just really anxious to see what's going to happen with that bracket. We were actually talking about what matches we're most excited for. And, well, Kevin, how about you?
I actually don't know the way the bracket lies out, so what are the two matchups? And I can tell you.
You know, I don't know that anybody knows, because, in fact, talking with both
You were just
Frank
speculating,
Adrian,
like, what matchups would you like?
They didn't know the bracket either.
I see what you're saying. I was about to say, I was like, oh, man, I don't even know this yet. okay, because it's apparently not been decided. It's two guests come up here for Oz before Cybernetics. Score, no real surprise. A lot of Protoss players have been doing that. The real surprise, though, is that he's already got three on the first guest. I don't know. Now knowing that Illusion's going to be there, I'm really interested in seeing Scarlet and Grubby play, and I'm really interested to see how Lucifron plays against Scarlet too, because obviously Lucifron has a very notorious, let's just make as many Hellions as possible and go kill our opponent very quickly in TBZ, and I wonder how Scarlet's going to deal with that. So those are the two matchups I'm really looking forward to.
Yeah, that actually, Lucifron versus Scarlet hadn't come up. I know a lot of us were actually excited at the possibility of seeing Grubby versus Lucifron. Grubby, his playstyle, his attitudes towards PvT, always changing. And Lucifron notoriously is like, I can take down one of the top best players, but seems to struggle when it comes to taking out a consecutive few. But hey, they are all foreigners at this tournament, so maybe he can make a little bit of a shining at that DICE event.
All right. Well, now for Oz, he's got a Sentry immediately following up his first Zealot. He has been mining off of three off of each Assimilator all the way since the very beginning, so there's a really large amount of gas coming in. Now, that could just mean a very quick Blink Stalker build, but going for that Sentry first, we're probably going to see some sort of tech here. Now, is it going to be Stargates? Are we going to see... Oh, actually, just opening with that Robotic Facility to begin with. Wants to get early Observers and check out his opponent, and could easily transition into Colossi after that.
Stalker's doing a really good job here from Scar, of course, in the beginning. Going to be scouting information, and, you know, there's a very particular way you want to go scouting here, as we see he is following up, in fact, with a Twilight Council versus Robo. This is already going to be some interesting developments here.
Yeah.
I made Twilight Council very strong on this map, particularly followed up by a Robo. You have the ability to blink into your opponent's main. Oz, on the other hand, looks like he's going to be playing more of a defensive game. He is continuing to make sentries here. If they were Stalkers, there would be the possibility of a Twilight Council follow-up, but that's fairly unlikely at this stage now.
And a Robotics Facility already on the way for Scar. So, yeah, two gateways for him. Looks like he's about to pop down a third. There it is. A lot of gas saved up, too. And we'll see if he very quickly goes up to that blink here, almost 150 minerals, and there it is. All right, so blink, observers. Obviously, this is going to be a big blink into the high ground somewhere around this path. And Oz, though, you already mentioned before that this is going to match up very interestingly, but he himself has that Twilight Council, Robotic Facility finished up, and two gateways.
Yes, he does. He is following up with the Twilight Council. He's not going to be able to make units out of these gateways for a little bit, although, you know, he did rush out that second one. But his warp gate's done now, so he'll be able to convert those momentarily. There they go, chrono boosting out that Immortal. And this is actually proving to be pretty interesting. I mean, Immortal with a Twilight Council, he's going to have the mobility available in order to defend while he goes for this expansion here. He could opt pressure with this, actually, if he throws down an additional gateway and move out. In fact, he's thrown them down, excuse me, the two gateways, of course, is what I mean with this. And this is not unpopular at all. We see players with the blink, it's a little bit different than we're used to seeing, but it's basically a four gate with an Immortal and blink.
yeah, you're going to sacrifice a little bit of army power because you didn't produce another unit with those, or two units of those 300 resources. But of course, you're going to have a lot more utility, and your positioning is going to be pretty effective too.
Oh my God, this is actually so intelligent. I mean, we're on Daybreak, Cloud Kingdom. I always call every map Daybreak, but we're on Cloud Kingdom. This is a map where Blink Stalkers are incredibly powerful, and so Oz is expecting his opponent to have very large Stalker counts. And as you mentioned, Kevin, he will have less units because he had to spend the money on the robotics facility itself. I mean, that costs money. That could be a unit. But in this situation, the fact that that unit that he made is an immortal, he's making a second one even, and this is going to be extremely powerful, if not in perfectly a build that is catered towards defeating the Blink Stalker on Cloud Kingdom.
Yeah, I think it's just going to do that. I mean, already Oz is, I don't think he has any intention of actually letting these pylons go up.
Yeah.
You know, the probe was scattered a long time ago. He just wants to hold the forces back until he gets his second immortal and he can start rallying in a bunch more units. Because all he has to do is stop one warp-in of units or stop one blink-in, and that's pretty much it, actually.
He does. I mean, he's going to be in a fantastic position tech-wise. He has two immortals on the field. This is just very, very powerful. Now, the pylon did get killed off. So Oz is going to have a difficult time being able to move out here because now Scar is on his side of the map. You know, ideally, Oz, managing to take out that unit. Very, very nice. But in this position, I mean, I just feel like Oz is going to be impenetrable right now.
Yeah, I mean, well, especially picking off the Observer. I mean, that's pretty much all he needs to do. I imagine, yeah, there is another one moving across the map, but he's going to directly engage this force right now. Blink's on top of the units, forces a Blink out from Shields or from Scar all the way back across the middle of the map, and that pretty much opens up everything now. Already, Scar knows this. He's decided to try and put up another Nexus, but fortunately for him, Oz is moving across the map with a gigantic force already.
And there it is. That's what I was looking for. Where's the probe that builds the pylon? Oz is throwing these down because this build is intended to be aggressive. If you're going for the tech, your Nexus is going to be forced to be later than your opponent's. They also still can capitalize on the mobility of their Stalkers because your Immortals aren't going to be with your army, so your Stalker count's lower. This is a build designed to be aggressive. The Gateway's going to be following this up. And Scar's going to have an extremely difficult time engaging against this. He only has one Immortal. He needs a couple more Zealots. There they are warping in right now. But the Stalkers of Oz blinking in and targeting down that Immortal immediately are huge for him. And I don't see how Scar's going to be able to beat this. The Guardian Shields making a world of a difference as well.
Oh, yeah. No kidding. I mean, pretty much perfect control there from Oz the entire way up. Forces the cancel on this Nexus already. And he's just going to try and punish this army right here. Another cool thing is he brought the perfect number of Zealots with him, too. He had just enough to be able to engage directly on his opponent's Immortal and simultaneously defeat the number of Zealots that his opponent had coming at him. And now it's just Immortals on Stalkers. We know how that goes. There's GG. Oz takes game number one.
It was a little scary there for a while when Scar got out on the map. He needed to stay on the map. Going instead for that expansion, not having the Stalker count, and losing the Observer was everything.
Yeah.
I mean, he did have that second one and may have been able to continue with that pressure, but when he lost his map position, because it's so hard for those Immortals to actually move out. The second he starts leaving the base, Scar can just blink in. And Scar wasn't able to capitalize on that, and then he loses the game when he has to fall back.
All right, guys. Well, that's game number one. Relatively quick game number one. We're going to run to a fast commercial break, and when we come back, it's going to be another PvP, this time on Daybreak, between Oz and Dream Team Gaming's Master Yi.